I have brand new free piano courses. The links are in the description below. And now enjoy this piano tutorial. Let me show you what you will learn in this tutorial. You should know this is not a song for beginners, but I will make it easy for you so that you can even master it as a beginner. Okay, well, you will learn even more in the more advanced parts, and I will show you exactly what you will learn there. But this is the first part. This is definitely possible for beginners. Well, it's not a beginner song, but I will make it easy for you. So later on, it becomes much more advanced, something like this. Yeah, and we will cover all this in this tutorial. Yeah, but we start easy and we'll cover everything. And again, I promise I will make it easy for everyone. So we start with the first part, which is where the left hand starts to play. And then we're adding the right hand. So this is the intro. This is what we will cover first, and we break it down in practice parts. First of all, in the left hand, we have the keys C and E. So we play the C with a pointer. So, and if you never sat on a piano before, when we have two black keys, we choose the left one and then go to the white key on the left side. This is the C. Yeah, this is where we have the pointer. And the thumb goes not on the D, but on the E, two white keys higher. We start with the thumb, and then we play these both notes one after the other. So the first practice part is really just play these two notes and try to play them as nice as possible. For example, not like this. Yeah, really like dum 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 dum, very steady. And then you can count till six, because we have a 6/8 bar here. And so we count like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so, and this is also the very first part. The left hand starts alone and it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, and then on this one, the right hand comes into play. So let's focus on the right hand now. The right hand plays A and B with thumb and pointer. So the A is when we have three black keys, you go to the middle, then to the white key on the right. This is the A. So we have A, B. So first practice part here in the right hand, just these two notes. It becomes tricky when we're adding the left hand, because we play 1, 2, 3. So both hands together, E and A, both thumbs, the left hand, then alone, so together. 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. That's this practice part. So I highly recommend Repeating this again and again, even 50 times, 20 till 50 times at least. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. It's totally fine if this is very slow. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay? So the thing is, the next one is we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, what changes here when the right hand plays the B, so this is the second practice part, the next one. The left hand goes from the C to the D. Okay? But we start with the E and B, and then the left hand. D, E, D, E. So it's the same that we had before, but not these two notes, and these two notes, and the right hand, not the A, but the B. And we count 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6. Okay, repeat this again and again here, E and B together. 4, 5, 6. And then we can play the first, these two practice parts together. So first we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so these are these two practice parts together. Take your time, pause the video, then we can go on. The third practice part. Again, the left hand plays E and C. Yeah, not the D, but here the C again. Oh, no, sorry. One more thing. No, because the real third practice part is we play 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is what we just had. And the left hand plays one bar more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sorry, I nearly forgot this because there's nothing new. It's very easy. But all together sounds like this. The left hand plays a whole bar alone, okay? So, and that's the third practice part. So very easy. The fourth one is this one. It looks huge, and yes, it's long, but not too complicated. First, let's focus on the right hand. So, the hand stays the same, thumb on the A, pointer on the B, middle finger on the C. And we start with the thumb, we go up, A, B, C, we go down, B, A, we go up, B, C, and this C here is a longer C, and then we go to the B, and it's a longer B also. So we have that's it. And you should also repeat this at least 20 times now to really memorize this. A, B, C, B, A, B, C, B. I do it one more time. But please take your time, pause the video, that you really repeat this a couple of times more, okay? The right hand should be able to play this very perfectly, and then the left hand plays E and C. E, C, E, C, E, C, E, C. Yeah, what we already had before. And together it looks like this. So The rule is here very simple. The right hand always plays when the left hand plays the thumb. So, together and the C alone. A left hand alone. Together, 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 left hand alone. And now together and left hand alone. And because the C is a longer note, we play the left hand also alone here. Like one, two, three. And then the right hand goes to the A. One, two, three. So, only the last two notes are longer, C and B. I play this again very slow. So, and this is the last practice part for the intro. I play it a little faster now. Okay, so this is the last practice part. Also, take your time, repeat this again and again that you're very confident in playing this. And then we bring everything together, the whole first part together, as the whole intro. So that's this. Great, and that's the intro, and the next part is where we play, yeah, the main theme, yeah, and but first of all, make sure that you're able to play this intro, and then we go on with the next part. So let's go on with the next part. This is the main theme. So a lot of things are based around this melody here. For example, this was one round, but we have six rounds. And the second round is like a little more advanced, like in the right hand we have one more note, or a few more notes. Then a little later we have this one. Yeah, but you can notice it's the same melody. It's always lum, bum, bum, bum. What's built in everything. Yeah? And for example, then later we have. Yeah, and then later we have even. Yeah, so it becomes larger and larger. And the reason why we do this here on the piano is because in the original song we have this orchestra with all the strings, and more strings are coming and more orchestra instruments, and it's becoming huge and dramatic. Before we have a huge third part. Yeah, so this is the second part. And yeah, we have quite a lot to do, but we make it very easy step by step. So first of all, in the right hand, we have the notes A and E. And these are all the notes we have in the first round. Only A with the thumb and E with the pinky. And right now I press the pedal with my foot. Without the pedal, it would sound like this. And with pedal, it sounds like this. This is the reason why we have the pedal on the piano. To keep the notes sound longer. So, and then we're adding the left hand. So this is a practice part, yeah? Take your time to repeat this in the right hand. A, E, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The left hand, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. F in the left hand. So, if this is too large for you, so we have F and F. Yeah, the F is when we have three black notes. We go to the left one and again to the left to the white key here. So we play this with the pinky and thumb. If this is too much for you, it's totally fine if you just play this F here. Yeah, this is just a little more, slightly fatter sound. Yeah, you can hear the difference. Okay, but I play it in the octave. This is how we call it when we play both Fs. This is the octave. And we play it on the when we count like one, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. When I count one, both hands together, 1, 2, the pinky, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Together, right, break, right, right, break. Together, right, break, right, right, break. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3. So this is the practice part. Okay, the next one is just that we go with the left hand from the F to the G, one white key higher. And the right hand don't play and doesn't play the A anymore, but with the pointer, the B instead. So it's B, E, B, E. B, B, but everything else stays the same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. A great practice part now is play the A. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. G and B. 3, 4, 5, 6, back to A and F and G and B. So these are the first two practice parts together. It's just a good next step to practice and to repeat. Okay, great. The third practice part is that the left hand goes from the G to A, one white key higher, and the right hand goes from the B to the C with a middle finger, C, E. So that's the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that's the third practice part. And the fourth practice part is we go from the C to the D with a ring finger. And the left hand goes down to the G again. So, and ring finger and pinky are weak fingers. So if you have problems with this at the beginning, that's totally normal. Yeah, everyone has this, and your pinky can't stand up like this, and it's hard to play the ring finger. It's just how it is at the beginning. Yeah, but I promise if you're patient and relax your hand and your arm and shake it and repeat this again and again, you will be able to play this. Be careful if your arm hurts, make a longer break. But that's just That's the process. Yeah, from time to time it will work. So in the left hand we have G, and then it's G and D together, and with a pinky E. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, great. All practice parts together are... So, this is the first round, and these are all four practice parts together. Now, please take your time that you're really very sure to play this and to practice this, because what we are doing in the following rounds is that we are building up on what we just learned, yeah? But this is definitely how we play this, the first round, yeah? And each round becomes a little more comprehensive, but this is how it goes. Okay, by the way, if you're still here now, I'm very, very sure you will love, not only like, but love my free piano course, both for beginners and for advanced or intermediate piano students. The link is in the description below, and I highly recommend getting this. It's totally free. Many, many of my subscribers are there, and we have so much fun in this community. You can send me an email and you get a response from me also. When you're in this crash course, yeah, it's really free, it's just fun, and check this out. I'm really looking forward to see you there. Okay, when you get your copy of my free piano crash course, then we can go on with the next round, with the second round. And this is so exactly what we just did, but the right hand plays this. So we are adding some more notes with a thumb. A, E, A, A, E, A. That's how it goes. Again. A, E, two times A, A, E, A. That's one. And when we repeat this again and again, and this is how you should practice it now, it's like this. Yeah, okay, so again and again, and that's all. So we apply the same pattern to the other notes, of course. So when we start with F again, B and G, but the same rhythm, dum, 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 C and A. Again, I play this a little slower. Oh, and the last note important is B. Again. A, B, G. B, C, and A. C, and then D and G. The last note is B, and again, a little slower, faster. Okay, this is the second round, but I have one more addition in the left hand. If you want, you can add, when you play the F and F, you can add the C with a pointer. That it sounds like this. Listen to the difference. Without the pointer, it's like this. And with, you can see it's a little more dramatic, the sound, right? So I personally like the sound, yeah? And it gives a little more spice to this. And it's also yeah, like it is in the original version. So I recommend doing this if you can. And now when we go to the G in the left hand, the pointer plays D. So when the left hand goes to the A, the pointer goes to plays E. It's always the middle note here. And back to G and in the middle the D. So, this is definitely the second round, yeah? The first round was just... And in the second round we have... So, a few more notes. So, round number 3 out of 6 is this one. This is definitely a little more comprehensive, but you can make it. So, the fingering in the right hand changes, yeah? Because we need the thumb on the E. The E is the new note. We don't have too many new notes, but now we don't play. Okay, for example, let's break it down even easier. So. This is what we just played, right? So we don't play this with thumb and pinky anymore. We play this with pointer and pinky anymore. So it's not the nicest way to play these two notes, but we need the thumb later for the E. But let's focus on these two fingers. We play the same notes, but with different fingers. Okay. This is the same finger, we had the middle finger and also the ring finger here before. Yeah, but this one here is new. And this is the next practice part for you that you can play this with a pointer. Especially this. Pointer, pointer. And now we are adding the E with the thumb. It's like... After each note we play here, after every A and after every E here with the pointer and pinky, we play the E with the thumb. But other than that, it's exactly what we had before. And this looks like this. A, E, bum, bum. So, and how I recommend to think, to practice is that you play only these two notes. Dun, 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 and that you focus on this melody. Dun, 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 dun. Let me play this slower. Dun, 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 dun. And then at the E. Dun, dun, dun. You should keep focusing on this melody, because this is the melody, and this E is just an accompaniment. And the hand has this slight move from thumb and the rest of the hand. Bum, 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 bum. So take your time with this, okay? Because the good news is Once you made this, we don't have anything new. Yeah, the next one again is G and B, what we had before. A. And always the E with the thumb here. And then D and G. And then the B at the very end. So again, very slow, everything together. So great! This is the third part. Not the third part. This is the third round. The first round was just this. The second round was this. And the third round is this. Yeah? We have three more rounds. So you should know the next three ones are definitely more advanced, and I highly recommend that you focus on these three rounds now, because if the following ones, the advanced ones, are too advanced for you, you can still play the entire song, the entire piece, because you can work with dynamic, that you start calm and you become louder. Yeah, and this is all we need. We need this effect that we have something happening there. And you can definitely do this just with dynamic, and that you become playing this louder, that your hands, your arm is a little heavier on the keys. So let me play everything for you that we did until this point before I share with you how you can go on. So I start from the intro, from the very beginning. Second round. So this is everything we just covered. You should know, even if the third round is too complicated for you, you can stay with this and try to make it play louder and make it more sound dramatic. All in all, we have six rounds before we have another part, a third main part of the piece. So what you should know, how we proceed from now. In the next part of my tutorial here, I'll share with you part, so we had the three rounds, and I share with you round 4, 5, and 6. These are more advanced rounds, okay? After these three more rounds, I share with you the third part, which is also, again, easier. It also becomes hard, but you definitely need the third part also as a beginner if you want to play the entire song. So stay with me in the next part of my tutorial series. And if you haven't got it yet, check out my link in the description to my free piano crash course. It's really free, it's really a lot of fun, and I really appreciate you seeing there. So thanks so much for being here, and let's go on with the next part. So welcome to my next tutorial part. Let's cover round 4, 5, and 6 from the second part, which is this one. We start like this. This is round number 4, and then it gets bigger and bigger. So this is what we will do next. This is definitely a little more advanced for beginners. I have the next tutorial part is something that you should definitely cover as well. So if you don't want to do this advanced thing here, you can go on with the next video. And also for beginners and also for advanced and intermediate piano students, check out the link in the description to my free piano courses. I have one for beginner and one for advanced piano players. They are free, totally free, and definitely a lot of fun. Okay, so everything we are doing now builds up on the third rounds we had before. Like we had this very simple one, and then we had this. Sorry, a little more notes, and then we had, yeah, so, but it was all based on this, around this melody. So this time we played like this. The left hand plays the same, the Fs and the C in the middle. The right hand now doesn't play the A alone anymore, but adds the E and the C here. And we play all these notes together. And then the pinky goes up to the E. And that's probably the biggest challenge, because we have a larger hand movement in the right hand. So we play A and E. And that's a great practice part, just to repeat these two notes. And the beauty is, what our brain can learn is when you repeat this again and again, like 50 times, 100 times, even if it's very slow, your brain will learn this movement, and then you can play this with even with closed eyes. Yeah, now I close my eyes, and you can see. Yeah, I'm not so 100% sure with this. I have to repeat this more often. Yeah, but it works. So that's magic. That's the beauty of our brain. So, and then you will be able to play it also this fast if you repeat this so often. Okay? So take this serious. It's also a lot of fun when it works. Okay, great. The next part is, the next step, the next practice part is this one. We not only play the B, but we are adding the G and E. So this is an E minor chord. The left hand again plays G, G, D. This is what we had before. And here the same, like the chord, and the pinky goes to the E. This time from B. B, E. B, E. And with the chord is. So that's the next practice part. Take your time, pause the video, then we can go on once you repeated this like at least 20 times, better 50 or 100 times. This is the next one. The left hand again, we have A, E, A. Nothing new here. The C is also not new, but the A and E. Thumb, middle finger, pinky. That's an A minor chord. All these notes together, and then with the pinky, E. So here's the practice part. This one, then this one. And then with the left hand together, like all hands together, right hand plays E. So, and when you repeat this again and again, it will go fast as well. Okay, great. Last chord is this one. Ha! We have four notes on the right hand, but the left hand plays G, D, G. The right hand plays this D, D here, and G, B, G, E. Thumb, pointer, ring finger, pinky. So, this is hard to play. If this is too hard for you, you can simply play these notes. You can leave, skip this E here. Yeah, it has a very similar sound effect. But if you are able to play it like this, wow, that would be amazing. Yeah, in the left hand plays the G's. And then, of course, the E. So it's very important, after you play this, leave the keys early enough so that you can kind of relax your hand before you play the E. So without my pedal, it sounds like this. Because I'm leaving these notes so early to play this E here. So I am playing this, but I leave them. Yeah, there's like a little break between these two notes. But the pedal helps me, making it sound like it's I hold them very, very long. Okay, the left hand, the G's. So that's the next practice part. Or the slightly easier one is this one. You can also hear the difference. Yeah, both works. Okay, so let's have a look at this whole round. And that was round number 4. 4 out of 6. Let's go on with round number 5. But of course, please take your time until you're able to play it like this, okay? So, round number 5 is only a slight difference in the right hand. Well, a slightly and big difference. I mean, now we don't play this E anymore. Well, we also play this, but we play the octave here. We play this with a thumb and also an E with the pinky here. Then we have... Yeah, but everything else stays the same. Yeah, because we play the E here all the time, now we play it with the octave. So, let's have a look here. And by the way, this is the practice part, only the right hand. And this can be very, very slow, like this, and back to the chord, and back to the octave. Take your time. This can be even slower than I'm doing it right now. As long as you repeat this at least 20 times. No, it's much better to this one, like at least 50 times. And then, but like after 30 times, you will notice that you can make it a little faster. And of course, I mean, don't do all this here in one day, because it helps when you sleep a night and your brain processes everything, and on the next day it even works better. And another night, a night of sleep, and your brain processes this again, and then you refresh and you practice this again. And you will be surprised how fast, like after a week or so, you will be able to play it like this. And even then, with closed eyes, okay. So I messed it up with closed eyes. Maybe a little slower. Now my eyes are closed. Ah. I have to repeat this more often. Ah, no. No, it's too early to close my eyes for me. Yeah. So, but you can see it's fast. And then we can at the left hand. And also do this for the other chords. But you should also repeat this for the other chords very often. Yeah, not only because you made it with the first chord, that's it. Yeah, also for this because it's always slightly different. And then, yeah. And this is, so you can see it's getting bigger and bigger. It's getting more dramatic. It's getting, yeah, this is what we're doing. And that was round number 5. So once you did this, we can go on with round number 6. And we have a little more in the left hand now. The left hand plays this pattern here. So, so the same notes that we had, but now we start with this F alone, go up to the C, F, back to C, and toggle between F and C here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1 on 1 is always the pinky, and on the other ones it's always pointer and thumb, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's the next practice part. You should spend some time with and repeat this again and again and again. And also count with this also loud. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you have two options. To be honest, I recommend this one. Like the F, and I'm correcting myself. The F on the 1 and also on the 4. Like 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, also on the 4, the pinky. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah? So this is the exact practice part. So, and you should be very confident in playing this before you adding the right hand, because it's getting bigger and bigger. Yeah? So, and this is with both hands together. Here's nothing new. This is what we did before on the 5th part, right? And then the next chord. Next one. Yeah. And that's the 6th round. Okay, but I mean, I haven't spent much time here on this tutorial because there's not much to do, but for you it's still much to do because you should have to. I highly recommend do a lot of repetitions. Yeah, this is really getting good at the piano if you put in the reps. So I have some more inspiration for you for this part. Okay, the inspiration is that you, instead of just playing a T, you can start one octave lower to make it even bigger. Yeah? Yeah, and then the chord here. Instead of just playing the F with the pinky here, you play it in the octave F. And I think you can't see my other F, but it's also the F, yeah? It's like this, but one octave lower. Instead of just the pinky, we play it 2 times. Yeah, and also, this is a practice part because there's a large hand movement. I mean, it looks easy when I do it, yeah, because I did it like a probably a couple, maybe a million times in my life. I have no idea how often I did something like this. A lot of times. Not just a thousand times, yeah? Really, definitely hundreds of thousands. Okay, yeah, so take your time for this. And this is just inspiration to make it just even larger and even more dramatic, yeah? And then... yeah. Okay, so that's just inspiration. And I gave you six rounds now before, which I'm going to play in a second for you all together. But you should know, as long as it's getting bigger and more dramatic, everything is fine. Yeah, if you, for example, do this as the sixth round and the even dramatic version with this version one round earlier than we did before, that's totally fine as long as it's getting more and more dramatic. So you have a couple of options there. But let me give you one option for all these six rounds. You know what? I start right from the beginning also with this intro. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry, F. This is round number 2. At the very end, we have E. Yeah, and you can play this once, at the left hand E, 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 E. Or you can shake your hands between left and right. Yeah, and it's not like both hands at the same time, it's really random. With pressed pedal, and it sounds like this. Hey, this can be very hard for your a lower arm, yeah, so make sure that you, when it hurts, that you take a break and that you relax it. Yeah, it takes also some practice just to make this. So, and then we go on with the third part, and this is what we're doing in the next video. Something like this. It's getting even more dramatic. Okay, but this is what we will cover in the next and last part. So yes, well, I'm super happy that you're still here. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. If you haven't got it yet, check out the links in the description to my free courses. I really appreciate it if you check them out, of course, because I love what I do and I love sharing it with other people. So thanks so much for being here, and see you in the free course and here in the next lesson. So welcome to the next part, and this is part number 3 of Interstellar. At the beginning we had the intro, and then the second part is with this main theme with this, which had 6 rounds, and it got bigger and bigger and so on. So, and today we have the 6th part. And also, if you haven't got them, check the link out to my free piano lessons. The link is in the description to beginner course and advanced intermediate course. Both are free and both are totally fun. And also in this video we have, it's not too complicated. So, the 3rd part. After we had this dramatic part here with we had this, then this, then this, and then even like, and at the end we had just the E. And this is where we are starting today. So, I know you couldn't see my keys on the left side, but I will explain everything. So that's it. That's today's part, and that's also the big finale of the song, of this piece. In the right hand, we have E and C. It's, and we play these notes one after the other. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the left hand plays A. So can you remember? Until now we had F, G, A, G. Yeah, that was very fast, but these were the notes. We started from the F and then we went up and back down to the G. Today we start with the A and then we are going lower. So we start with A. That's the first practice part. We start with the pinkies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. For advanced players, I have a little more advanced version of this also later. But the easy one and the main thing is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's the practice part you should spend some time with now and repeat this again and again. The next part is the right hand plays D and G. Yeah, from C and E goes to D and G. And the left hand goes down to G. But everything else is the same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And a great practice, because this is not too hard to practice just to stay on these notes here, is to start with the first one. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And now we have E and A here. The pinkies go to G and D to the second practice part. So, and that's a great way to practice first this chord and then this chord, especially the transition between both of them. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, pinkies, G and D. 4, 5, 6. Okay, so these are the first 2 practice parts. Then we have the next one. The right hand goes from G and D to A and E, and the left hand goes lower to F. Yeah, but everything else stays the same. And now, the 4th practice part, we go from A and E to E and B. That's a big jump, But the thing is, the E that's played by the pinky here is now played with a thumb. So that's easy to remember. And the hand itself also stays as it is. So we don't have to change the position. We change the position, but not the wideness of the hand, right? A and E, E and B. A and E, E and B. So that was the third one. And the fourth one is this one. Yeah? So, and the left hand, we had, let me see, we had, the left hand goes, I'm back up to the G now. Achtung, the left hand, the pinky G, and the right hand, the B. So, and you probably already know it's best to practice these guys here. So that's the third and fourth practice part. Take your time, spend some time with these guys and repeat them again and again. And then you can repeat all four practice parts, like this one. Four, five, six, G and D. Four, five, six, E and F. Four, five, six, G and B. Four, five, six. So that's great. Take your time for this four practice parts. Then we have two more. The next one is very similar to the first one. Well, it is the first one, with the only difference that we don't play E and C here, but one octave higher. And what I sometimes do and already did before when I played this, I also played the left hand one octave lower. This sounds even more dramatic, yeah? But you don't have to do it. This is also already dramatic. It's up to you, okay? It's only a slight difference. One, two, three, four, five, six. The good news is also the next one is something we already had. That's the same as the second practice part. And then we have again the E's. E, 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 E. And you can play it like this or just one time. And that's it. That's the piece, and we can start from the very beginning then again. So let me play this whole part for you, and after this I give you some more options, also some more advanced options. But for both, for beginner and advanced. So, first of all, we start like this. From the beginning, yeah? So this is, for example, there's one video on YouTube with the most views, like more than 100 million views. And in this video, this whole piece, what I just showed you, is like repeated, I think, 5 times or so. Yeah, because I could play this for hours, yeah? Always repeating and repeating it because there's so much life in this music. Okay, but I wanted to show you one more option. So, we played it like this, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the third part, today's third part. We can definitely play it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, and that's the beginning again. So what did I just do? Everything what we had before, but I didn't play it so straight, like 1, 2, 3. I was shaking my hands again. 1, 2. And there is no, I don't count these notes. It's just shaking back and forth. It's very random. Also, the left and right hand is not doing the same. Yeah, so, but I'm counting in my head. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1. And what I do always with the 1, this is louder than this. 1, that's loud. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then I'm getting louder, like. Yeah. 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, louder. Yeah, so you should know this is really advanced because it can really hurt here in your lower arm if you don't relax, if you don't take your time. This is something you practice over days, yeah, over weeks. If you want, I mean, you also have to like this. Both is definitely fine. The version I showed you before, but I wanted to share this as an option for you to try. Okay, no, I mean, that's it. That's the entire masterpiece, Interstellar by Hans Zimmer. I mean, yeah, what a piece. I really, really hope you enjoy this. I mean, if you're here, congratulations. You can be really, really proud. Maybe you have something to do, but that's totally fine. Enjoy this journey. I really appreciate that you're here. I will upload a video where I play this entire piece for you, yeah, and then you can have a look again at my fingers, how I play everything together and maybe get some more inspiration. I'll definitely link this in the description below. Same for the free courses that I have there. And I'm always looking forward to your visit on my website. It's verdemusica.com. I really appreciate it. I'm so happy that you're here. Thank you so much. And I'm looking forward to see you in the next tutorial.